بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This question is one of the common questions in Arab board, Saudi board, Jordanian board, and Egyptian board. We'll see our scenario. So this one actually, this is 1 day old infant, and who was born by difficult forceps in delivery is alert and active. This is the first clue in this questions. Difficult delivery and difficult forceps delivery. There is instrumental delivery. Difficult delivery. Once you hear difficult delivery, think about birth injury, birth asphyxia, birth trauma, and all of this you have to think about it. Birth difficult forceps delivery, birth asphyxia, birth trauma, birth injuries. All this can be associated with the difficult delivery. She does not move her left arm. She does not move her left arm. However, what she keeps internal rotated by her side with the forearm extended and pronated, and she also does not move in during the Moro reflex. Moro reflex. So this one actually is specific position. This is a specific position. This is the shoulder of this baby. Actually, it's having adduction and internal rotation, and the elbow, it will extend it, elbow extended. You see here, this is the elbow extended. We'll see in this baby here, this baby here, this one, you see here, here, this is the shoulder, shoulder, adduction, adduction, and internal rotation. If you look for the elbow, elbow extension with pronation, with pronation, and you see the wrist is actually is flexed, flexed. So flexion, it will be flexion. This is characteristic features of what? Erbs palsy. Brachial injury, brachial plexus injury, or herpes palsy injury. This is correct. We call it waiter position or policeman position. Waiter position or policeman position. It will be shoulder. You have shoulder, you have elbow and wrist. The shoulder, it will be internal rotations and adduction. And regarding the elbow, it will be extension and pronation. And regarding the wrist, it will be flexion. It will be waiter position or policeman position. This is correct. Characteristic for herpes palsy injury or brachial plexus injury. So the questions here, the rest of her physical examinations is normal. This clinical picture most likely indicate what? So you have 1 day old baby girl with difficult forceps delivery. So any difficult delivery, both in your mind, birth asphyxia or perinatal asphyxia, and birth injury, and birth injury or birth, we call it birth trauma or birth trauma. So the baby was having abnormal position of the left hand, of the left hand. So abnormal position of the left hand indicate what? Indicate injury, birth injury. What kind of this injury? It might be brachial plexus injury or fractures, or fractures. So we'll see here, this is the clinical picture most likely to indicate it what. So your impression, it's herpes palsy from your, from the position of the baby. This is indicate this baby having brachial plexus injury, brachial plexus injury. So a fracture of the clavicle could be fracture clavicle, and also P, fracture of the left humerus. Yes, could be fracture clavicle or fracture humerus. But why I will exclude the clavicle and the humerus? Because the fracture clavicle or humerus is no characteristic position. No characteristic position for fracture clavicle or fracture humerus. And also there is pain with passive movement. There is pain with passive movement. So by these two features, I will exclude this is fracture clavicle or fracture humerus. And for sure, I have to do X-ray to also to confirm my impression. So the fracture clavicle or humerus, no specific or characteristic position. And also there is pain with passive movement. If we see that here, the C, left-sided herpes Duchenne paralysis. So actually, this is the appropriate answer based on what? Based on the history of difficult labor and forceps delivery, and also based on the position of the baby. The position of the baby is characteristic for herpes palsy and characteristic for brachial plexus injury, especially the upper brachial plexus injury. The position of the shoulder and the elbow and wrist. Shoulder adduction, internal rotation, elbow extension and pronations, and the rest it will be flexion. This is pronation like this. Supination, it will be supination. Subhanallah, it's called subhanallah. Pronation, it will be like this. It's okay. The D left sided clambic paralysis. Why is not clambic paralysis? How to differentiate between the herpes and clambic? Actually, the herpes, it will be C5 and C6. It's okay. The clambic, it will be C7 and 8 and T1. This is regarding the injury. So the herpes, it will be the upper brachial plexus injury, and the clambic, it will be lower brachial plexus injury. In the upper brachial plexus injury, in the herpes, it will be shoulder, it will be bad, and the hand, it will be good. Because that it will be internal rotation, and hand there is grasp reflex, it will be present. Grasp reflex, the baby can catch anything. Grasp reflex is present. In clambics, actually, it will be, this is lower plexus injury. So the hand, it will be bad, and the shoulder, it will be good. So in clambics, it will be what? It will be claw hand. It will be claw hand. So grasp reflex, it will be absent. Grasp reflex, it will be absent. So this is how to differentiate between the herpes and clambics. And also the herpes, it will be associated with phrenic nerve injury. Phrenic nerve injury between C3 to 5. Phrenic, it will be 4. Phrenic, it will be C4. Phrenic 4, it will be it affects the C4, it will be affected, and baby will present with respiratory distress, it will be or diaphragmatic paralysis. In clambics, it will be associated with what? Horner syndrome, ptosis, meiosis, anhidrosis, and enophthalmos. So our appropriate answer, it will be the left-sided herpes Duchenne paralysis, based on what? Based on the there is difficult forceps delivery, and also the second issue regarding the position of the baby is called waiter position, is called policeman positions, shoulder, elbow, and wrist, shoulder, adduction and internal rotation, and elbow extension and pronation, and the rest, it will be flexion. It will be اللي بياخد البقشيش. It will be waiter or policeman. This is the continuation of this question. Actually, this is question 18. It will be the infant is proceeding questions immediately develop both the kidney and sinus. With sinus, this baby having also this is waiter positions, or to call it herpes palsy, and the baby start to having the kidney and sinuses. She is improved somewhat on oxygen, but has predominantly thoracic breathing movement, and chest x-ray was appeared to be having taken inadvertently at expirations seems normal. The procedure most likely to provide a specific etiological diagnosis is. So put in your mind, what is the differentiation between the herpes palsy and clambic paralysis? Herpes palsy, you have to put in your mind, it will all the time, not all the time, actually, it will be associated with phrenic nerve injury. Phrenic nerve injury, and it will present with diaphragmatic paralysis or asymmetry or paradoxical movement, or it will present it with what diaphragmatic paralysis. Tachypnea and cyanosis, it will be respiratory symptom. It will present with respiratory, sometimes lung atelectasis, sometimes lung atelectasis. In herpes, it will be associated with Horner syndrome. So this baby, it was having herpes and start to have respiratory symptoms, tachypnea and cyanosis, improved with oxygen, and symmetry or paradoxical movement indicate there is phrenic nerve injury. Phrenic nerve injury. So the brachial plexus or herpes palsy, it will be upper brachial plexus. It will be C5 and C6. And the phrenic nerve, it will be from 3 to 5. It means 4. It will be 4 phrenic. This is means it's affected because the baby is present with respiratory symptoms. So this is our impression. This also herpes palsy with phrenic nerve injury or the diaphragmatic paralysis. What is the diagnostic procedure are going to do? A is venous blood gas. No, actually is not the one to diagnose. It can monitor the patient with the blood gas to check if this patient is need ventilation or not, or whatever the respiratory failure or not respiratory failure, to monitor the patients. CT scan of the head. The patient in the question, it was alert and active and all of this. Sometimes the patient, there is injury or can be present with respiratory symptom, but not the case. Ultrasound or fluoroscopy of the chest. This is the answer. Ultrasound or fluoroscopy of the chest. Fluoroscopy, it will actually the significant fluoroscopy, you can see the diaphragmatic movement during especially the inspiration. You see the patient, it will take the inspiration, so that the phlegm, it will come down. in actually in the phrenic nerve, diaphragm will never come down. It will be actually, it will be elevated. But in the other side, in the normal side, it will come down. But in the affected side, it will be actually, it will be elevated, is not moving due to diaphragmatic paralysis. It will be elevated diaphragm during inspiration, and there is paradoxical movement during the inspiration during the due to diaphragmatic paralysis because the phrenic nerve injury So the and you can broncho alveolar lavage. This is not the answer, and the blood culture because the baby symptomatic. Able to accept the corcarb and sorted antibiotic, but you know the cause why this baby having tachypnea and cyanosis and distress, because actually this patient having herpes palsy, and herpes palsy it will be associated with phrenic nerve injury, especially the C4 for phrenic nerve, and C5 and 6 for the upper brachial plexus of the herpes palsy. So the answer it will be I have to do ultrasound or fluoroscopy looks like x-ray with contrast, x-ray with contrast, and looking for the diaphragmatic movement. It will be on the affected side, it will be no movement, or the diaphragm it will be elevated, and the other diaphragm it will come down because it's normal, it's contralateral diaphragm, it will be normal. So this is the clinical presentation of the herpes palsy. Call it waiter or policeman. It will be, you see, this is the characteristic position of this patient. You see the shoulder, you have to shoulder, elbow, wrist, adduction and internal rotations, and the elbow it will be extension and pronation, and the wrist it will be flexion. This is characteristic positions of the herpes palsy, and by this position we diagnose the patient having herpes or upper brachial plexus injury. You see the hand, the grasp reflex it will be preserved. Why? Because in herpes the upper brachial plexus it will be injured, so the shoulder it will be bad and the hand it will be good. But in Climbics, it will be the opposite. If you see here, this is the climbics. This you call it claw hand, because the climbics it will be the lower brachial plexus injury. It will be bad hand and normal shoulder. So the baby cannot do grasp reflex, cannot do grasp, and associated with what? Horner syndrome, ptosis, meiosis, anhidrosis, enophthalmos. This is Horner syndrome. This is the Horner syndrome associated with Climbics paralysis. If you see here, this is the left eye here. Ptosis, meiosis. You see small eyes. Ptosis, meiosis, anhidrosis. This means dryness. Anhidrosis, enophthalmos. This is the phrenic nerve injury. This is the X-ray. If you see here, this is X-ray. This is the left hemi diaphragm. It will be, you see here, this X-ray demonstrate markedly elevated of the left hemi diaphragm with shifting of the heart and the mediastinum to the right. You see the diaphragm, it's elevated during inspiration. It will be a paradoxical movement, and it will be diaphragmatic paralysis due to phrenic nerve injury. If you see here, also, if you see here, this is more clear. Here is more clear. You see the diaphragm elevated. You see the diaphragm is elevated. You look for the other side, it will be down. You see, this means that this area, the hemi diaphragm here, is injured because phrenic nerve injury led to elevation of the diaphragm during inspiration or paradoxical movement. Here, this is the fluoroscopy. You see, it's normal X-ray with contrast. You see the here. You see the diaphragm is elevated. You see the diaphragm and it's not moving. Actually this paradoxical movement was in aspirations because one part of the hemisphere, the hemi diaphragm, it's affected or injured. So this patient, it will be the phrenic nerve, it will be C3 to 5, and almost it will be C4 phrenic, and it will be presented with respiratory distress, tachypnea, cyanosis, and it will be having risk of the infection, and also elevated of the hemi diaphragm with paradoxical diaphragmatic movement. Sometimes will be associated with atelectasis, with because diaphragm is paralysis. But there's no movement, the secretion, and it will be accumulated to collapse or atelectatic changes. If no improvement within 1 month, recovery unlikely and diaphragmatic glycation it will be considered. So difficult delivery during the traction of the neck and all of this, it will be associated with injury. The Erbs palsy, it will be the C5 and 6, it's called upper brachial plexus injury. It will be characteristic position of the waiter or the policeman, and also Klemmbeck's paralysis, it will be C7 and C8 with T1 associated with Horner syndrome. Fracture of the upper limb is not associated with what? Characteristic butchers, and would be associated with what? Pain with passive movement. But about what about the spinal injury? It causes complete paralysis. Sometimes it will be complete paralysis of the upper brachial and the lower brachial. It will be brachial plexus, and also it will be cause complete paralysis below the level of the injury, below the level of the injury. Phrenic nerve injury, it will be, this is a C3 to 5, almost is 4, and this is phrenic nerve injury led to paradoxical movement of the diaphragm, especially during the inspiration, asymmetrical diaphragmatic movement, asymmetric, and the diagnosis with fluoroscopy. Do x-ray with contrast, it will be diagnosed with fluoroscopy, and the injury frequently improve spontaneously. If you see here, this is what is called Erbs palsy. This is will be how to differentiate between the Erbs and the Klemmbeck's. The Erbs, it will be the lesion, it will be upper brachial plexus C5 and 6, and if it will be associated with phrenic nerve injury between C3 to 5, almost it will be 4. But Klemmbeck's, it will be the lesion, it will be lower brachial plexus, it will be C7 and 8 and T1. It will be rare, and it will be associated with Horner syndrome. Sometimes it will be total paralysis, it will be Kerr's paralysis, so it will be the worst. This is total paralysis, upper and lower. It's upper brachial plexus, call it Erbs. It will be a bad shoulder with normal hand, or lower brachial plexus, so call it Klemmbeck's. It will be normal or good hand with bad shoulder, or all it will be paralysis, or total, it call it total paralysis. Erbs palsy, we said C5 and C6 also. And the most characteristic feature, it will be the hand, it will be normal grasp reflex, and associated with phrenic nerve injury. And what in your mind, it will be the baby presents with asymmetrical butchers of the heart, asymmetrical butcher, and it will be waiter tip, and baby demonstrate the finding of the left-sided Erbs paralysis. Klemmbeck's, it will, the lesion, it will be the lower brachial plexus C7 and 8 and T1. But in your mind, it will be claw hand, not writing hand. You see, claw hand or not writing hand. The baby cannot do grasp reflex, and associated with Horner syndrome. You see Horner syndrome, this Horner syndrome, it will be ptosis, meiosis, and hydrosis, enophthalmia. This is the total paralysis. It will be associated with muscle hypotonia, and it will be actually call it Kufrit syndrome. If it was associated with phrenic nerve injury, it will be there is diaphragmatic paralysis because irregular breathing, cyanosis, can be associated with pneumonia, atelectasis, collapse. It will be mistaken as pneumonia. The patient may be mistaken as pneumonia. So this is the different position for the baby. This is the Erbs, it's called it waiter hand, and this is the actually complete brachial plexus injury. This is complete, and this is the Klemmbeck's paralysis. It will be claw hand. You see here, for sure, any patient with weakness in the arm, or abnormal Moro reflex, or you suspect any problem with the hand, you have to do x-ray. But in your mind, don't do unilateral x-ray. You suspect this is clavicle fracture, but in your mind, is not clavicle fracture alone, can be humerus also. So you have to do the whole limb x-ray. You have to do x-ray for the clavicle and the humerus. Clavicle and humerus, you have to do clavicle and humerus. Don't do clavicle only, you have to do clavicle and humerus. And don't do only one side, you have to do both sides. You have to do on the both side, both clavicle. You have to be sure about the both clavicle and also both humerus and x-ray. So you have to do chest x-ray and upper limb x-ray, looking for clavicular fracture, humerus fracture, and also for elevation of the diaphragm if this association with phrenic nerve injury. Don't do one سايد. دونت دو ذيس از براكتيكال تيبس، ريلي براكتيكال تيبس اند ميديكال ليجال تيبس، ميديكال ليجال تيبس ويل دو جاست اونلي اون وان سايد اند اذر سايد مي بي ذير از اولسو سمول فراكشر اور لينير فراكشر كانوت ديتكتد. سو يو هاف تو دو ان بوث سايد اند كومبير بوث سايد اند اولسو ذا هيومرس بوث سايد اند شيست اكس راي لوكينج فور اني اليفيشن اوف ذا ديافرام اف ذير از اني فرينيك نيرف انجري. ذيس از ذا هيومرس فراكشر اولسو نو كاركترستيك بوزيشن اند بين ويز باسيف movement. This phrenic nerve injury, phrenic nerve actually it will be C3 to 5 or almost 4 and it will be paralysis of ipsilateral diaphragm and the baby will present it with respiratory distress and diminished breath sound on the affected site and you have to do chest x-ray. It are going to looking for what? Looking for the elevation of the affected diaphragm because during inspiration should be that the diaphragm has come down, but the diaphragm is paralysis, so it will not come down. It will be elevated, and the other side it will be normal. The contralateral side will be normal. Sometimes it will be associated with mediastinal shift. With mediastinal, how to diagnose? You have to do ultrasound or fluoroscopy to confirm diagnosis by showing what? Paradoxical diaphragmatic movement during inspiration. This is characteristic. Paradoxical diaphragmatic. Paradoxical means asymmetrical. Asymmetrical diaphragmatic movement during inspiration. You see. Here you see this is you see here is elevation of the diaphragm, elevation of the this is the fluoroscopy, this is fluoroscopy. So the phrenic nerve injury, what is the treatment? You have to give supportive treatment, oxygenation, hydrations, and respiratory. If there is any respiratory failure, you have to treat with mechanical ventilations and gavage bead and the application of the diaphragm if needed. Upper plexus, this means bad shoulder, good hand. Lower plexus, good shoulder and bad hand. So put in your mind, any patient with weakness, there is weakness in the arm, there is weakness or abnormal Moro reflex or asymmetrical Moro reflex, what are going to do? You have to assist this patient for brachial plexus injury or any fractures so by the position of the baby you can detect which lesion. This is upper brachial plexus injury or lower plexus brachial plexus injury or total brachial plexus injury. And also any patients having asymmetrical Moro reflex, you have to do x-ray. What x-ray? Is not only clavicle, you have to do also the humerus. Sometimes the clavicle normal but the humerus is fractured, so you have to screen this baby, the clavicle and the humerus and the chest also, the clavicle looking for any fracture, and you have to do both to compare both, and also the humerus both to compare both also. Sometimes you will hidden fracture in other area or linear fracture, you can't detect it. This is medical legal issues. Then you have to do also x-ray. Looking for what? Looking for any other association with the herpes palsy like phrenic nerve injury. It will be what? It will be elevation of the diaphragm, elevation on the affected side. On the affected side, if there is affections, you have to do also fluoroscopy or ultrasound to confirm your diagnosis. So how to differentiate between the herpes and the clympics? So herpes, it will be upper brachial plexus injury. So it will be bad shoulder, good hand. So in the characteristic position of this herpes palsy, it will be you have shoulder, elbow, and wrist. Shoulder, it will be internal rotation and adduction and the extension of the elbow and pronation, and it will be flexion of the wrist. This is characteristic position for herpes. For clympics, it will just a claw hand or abnormal hand or not writing hand. It will, and also grasp reflex, it will be absent. But in the herpes, the grasp reflex, it will be present. Why? Because the herpes is upper brachial plexus injury. So the shoulder bad and hand, it will be good. In the clympics, the hand it will be bad and the shoulder it will be good. And the herpes it will be C5 and 6, and in the clympics it will be C7 and 8 and T1. If the herpes it will be associated with phrenic nerve injury, it will be between C3 and 5, it will be 4, you call it phrenic, it will be 4, and the baby it will be presented with respiratory distress. It will mistaken as pneumonia or collapse or atelectasis. But if you are digging in the history, there is difficult delivery or forceps delivery, and the baby having abnormal Moro or a paradoxical movement, or the patient's having actually elevated diaphragm in the x-ray will give you hint this patient having phrenic nerve injury, phrenic nerve, rather than mistaken with pneumonia or collapse or whatever or whatever. In the Climbix, it will be common associated will be Horner, ptosis, meiosis, and hydrosis, and also it will be C, what C7 and 8 and T1, and also Climbix, it will be the hand. What is the problem with that? Climbix, it will be lower brachial plexus injury, it will be hand. What hand is bad and shoulder is good, and it will be claw hand. Don't forget again, don't forget to do x-ray both clavicle and both humerus and chest, and chest rule out any fracture. Before you mention this patient having brachial plexus injury or herpes palsy, you have to rule out first fracture clavicle, fracture humerus, and also you have to rule out any phrenic nerve injury, and also you have to examine the eye for Horner syndrome. This is one of the common association with what? With Climbix palsy. But put in your mind, the common injuries, it will be herpes palsy, not Climbix. Common injury, it will be herpes rather than the Climbix. Common is common. ومن أحيا فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا. الله أسأل الله رب العرش العظيم ينجح كل زملائنا داخلين اختبارات عرب بورد, سعودي بورد, جردون بورد, ليبيان بورد, and Egyptian بورد. نسأل لهم النجاح والتوفيق. شكرا, سلام عليكم.